Hello YouTube. In the previous video, we added an additional SSD to the Asus G15. Now I'll show you how to transfer the entire disk image with the Windows 11 installation to another larger SSD. This tutorial works for any Windows computer, so it's not specific to just this laptop model. Let's get started. The first step is to create a bootable Windows 11 USB stick or external disk drive. Don't worry, we won't be reinstalling Windows. It's also recommended that you backup all the important data on the computer, just in case something goes wrong. To create a bootable Windows USB drive, download the Windows 11 ISO image from the official Microsoft site. Then, download the Rufus bootable USB creation tool and use it to create a bootable USB stick. It's quite straightforward. Plug the empty USB stick into the computer, open the Rufus tool, select the USB stick drive as the device, and for a boot selection, choose your previously downloaded Windows 11 ISO image. Then, click Start and wait until the tool finishes creating the bootable Windows 11 image on the USB stick. With that done, close the Rufus tool and let's continue with the next step, which is downloading Macrium Reflect. In the past, this software was free for home use, but now there is just a 30-day trial available. However, the trial does the job anyway. Once it's downloaded, install and open it. In the opened window, select your disk with the Windows installation with the checkbox on the left. Then select Clone the disk. In the Clone window, select Copy partitions with exact partition offset and length. Since the original disk is 1 TB and the new one is 2 TB, there is 1 TB of unused space on the right. To fix this, select the rightmost partition and click on Float Right. Repeat this for all partitions so that you will have unused space after the OS partition. With that done, select the OS partition and use Fill Space. This will merge the OS partition with the unused space, and when you have everything set up, click Next and the cloning should begin. After finishing cloning, restart the computer and press and hold F2 key on the keyboard to enter BIOS. For other computers, the key might be different, so please check for your specific computer model. Change the boot priority on the right side so that the new larger disk is at the top priority. Save and exit the boot menu. Now, when the computer is booted, your new larger disk should be listed as the C drive if you check in File Explorer. Now you can reformat your old disk, as up till this point, both disks have the same data. Restart the PC and you will probably be greeted by a Windows blue screen and the following error. To fix that, plug in your USB Windows recovery drive, restart once more and boot from the USB. Setting in BIOS should enable USB boot. When the recovery media is loaded, go to Advanced Options and select Command Prompt. First, use this command to scan where the Windows installation is present. Your results should be like that. Then use BCD boot and the location from the command before. With that done, restart the computer and the error should be gone. For some reason, on my side, the Microsoft Store disappeared with all related apps upon logging in. To fix that, open PowerShell and run the following command. To reinstall all built-in apps, there is an additional command, but I did not use that, as at the same time, I was happy that a lot of Microsoft bloatware was gone with it. I just installed the apps that I use. That's it for this video. I hope it was helpful, and please subscribe for more content like this. Thanks for watching.